I'm still trying to, I'm having a hard time wrapping my head around this. Mr. Alexander, if there are over 20,000 Puerto Rican American citizens still without power, is your mission really accomplished?
Our mission, as assigned by FEMA, is?
I don't think that's acceptable. I cannot imagine a scenario where 20-plus thousand Texans or 20-plus thousand Floridians were without power and FEMA would make that decision. I think that's reprehensible. Mr. Moses, I want to get to the bottom of something you raised that I think is a bit of a game changer here. Puerto Ricans pay painfully high retail electric rates, both individual citizens and manufacturers. I can't imagine a world where you try to make manufacturing work at 20-plus cents per kilowatt hour. A lot of that's because of an antiquated over-reliance on diesel generation, which is incredibly expensive. So at a time when we see new generation from wind, from solar, from natural gas, all priced in the bulk market at 2 to 4 cents, even 2 to 5 cents a kilowatt hour, it seems to me that even on the retail price, we ought to be able to build new generation cheaper than operating the existing diesel generation. Am I missing something here?
By all means, but let's get back into the material question.
They
talked about the inventory is not a problem anymore because it's being handled. What about in the next 3 or 4 months? If we are hit again, is the inventory there? Because they fix what was broken the last 2 or 3 months. But what about if we get hit again? Are we going to go through this again? Of course, if we own our generation, we will have the inventory available to fix our problems. Yes, sir.
So what are the barriers to your members being able to own their own generation, their own storage, their own behind-the-meter distributed resources that then can not only support your members, but in an emergency, potentially provide services back to the grid?
Well, not just in an emergency, because we could design it in order to share our access with the community and other components of the region. So, I mean, we could design all this on a proper way to help everybody in Puerto Rico.
Why can't you do that today?
Well, we have not been able to do that in the past because typically PREPA protect their invoice. Remember that we are the biggest invoice of the utility company. So they may be concerned about this kind of trend. And yes, in terms of technologies, solar, wind, there's many others that are there available and that could make things very nice.
Mr. Higgins, what is the prepper legal stance with regard to behind-the-meter resources, with regard to solar and storage for individual retail customers, as well as with regard to large commercial customers being able to have behind-the-meter generation?
Senator Heinrich, I think the question needs to be answered in kind of two ways. Number one, Puerto Rico needs to change the way the grid is supplied by power today. It is not being adequately and properly supplied with the current generation mix. That generation is troubled by a maintenance issue. It's troubled by being reliant on oil, which is both environmentally and cost-wise a difficult commodity. And in addition, there's not enough generation where it needs to be, and in some cases, there's too much where we don't need it. So the grid needs to be rebuilt. It needs to be rebuilt. Not just the wires, but the generation needs to be rebuilt. And as we change it out, and I agree with Mr. Moses in that regard, we should be relying on customers to generate themselves. We should be allowing customers who want to self-generate do so. We need to interconnect with them safely such that the grid is still safe, the workers can still work without danger, and the customer is able to supply what they want to. And PREPA in the new world will supply what PREPA is capable of supplying for people that don't want to do it themselves or when it's more economic.
So, do you have a current net metering policy either for retail or for large commercial users?
As I understand the retail policy, I've not spent a lot of time looking into that in my short time there. a customer, in order to be a retail solar customer and still be connected to the grid, must have a system that supplies their own needs and have storage. Therefore, they aren't going to suddenly rely on the grid when their system doesn't work. That, I believe, is our current way of dealing with behind-the-meter solar.
Thank you.